Breaking news out of Arkansas. RIP. What would you do if your wife turned off the football game you were watching while you stepped out to have a smoke? Would you simply turn it back on or would you violently stab her to death? Myself, I'd simply turn the game back on, but that's not how it went in one house in Arkansas. Check this out. An Arkansas man was charged with capital murder Monday after he reportedly murdered his wife for turning off a football game, Fox News reports. Tony Thomas, 58, of Carlisle, admitted to investigators that he fatally stabbed his wife, Elk, on November 19 after she changed the television channel from football while he was taking a smoke break outside, the Arkansas Democrat Gazette reported. When Tony Thomas, 58, came back inside and saw the channel has been changed, he asked his wife, Elk Thomas, what the score was of the football game he'd been watching, according to a court document. Thomas told police his wife began yelling at him and an argument ensued. He got a knife from the wall and began stabbing her, according to an affidavit from Anthony Counts, a detective with the Lonoke County Sheriff's Office. He claimed he'd blacked out and when he came to, he was over her with a knife in his hands, Lonoke County Sheriff's Detective Anthony Counts wrote in an affidavit. Deputies were already responding to the scene because a woman who had been at the home flagged down someone passing by to report the stabbing. Thomas then called the sheriff's office and asked for a meat wagon and police because he had just killed his wife, Counts wrote in the affidavit. Police found blood on the floor, walls, a table and the TV, and Counts wrote it appeared the wife's body had been dragged through the dining room to the backyard, where it was found beneath a blanket and a tarp. Thomas was being held in the Lonoke County Jail, the Gazette reported. Court records show his bond is set at $1 million. A court hearing for Thomas, who was reportedly charged as a habitual offender because he had previously been convicted of felony crimes, is scheduled for January 22. Damn. That's what I would call total insanity. Rest in peace, young lady.